I don't know what you're saying.
Where you take a picture of yourself and you put it on Facebook and let everybody see it.
When do you take a picture of yourself?
Oh, they do it. They do it.
I don't.
Oh, no, you don't and I don't. But they do.
Who's they?
Other people. I gotta try that sometime.
I had enough pictures taken of me. I didn't have to take my own picture.
So tacky, who wears cheetah? It's not even so tacky, who wears cheetah? It's not even summer. Why does the DJ keep on playing Summertime Sadness? After you get out of the bathroom, can we go smoke a cigarette? I really need one. But first, let me take a selfie.
I love selfies.
I want to look tan. What should my caption be? I want it to be clever. How about living with my bitches, #live? I only got 10 likes in the last 5 minutes. Do you think I should take it down? Let me take another selfie.
I was 10 when I got my first phone, and I use it every day to text my friends. Calm banging on your chest. You could beat the world. You could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands. You got a phone?
Yes, I do.
How come?
Well, you can text your friends and call them, and you can kind of like watch, look at funny pictures, cats playing the piano.
I got my first phone and I use it to text my friends.
I know someone who was bullied over text.
At the concrete plant where she left to her death, friends of Rebecca Segway created a makeshift memorial. These stuffed animals and balloons reflect just how young she was, 12 years old. Her mother, Tricia Norman, says her daughter's suicide came after months of bullying on social media and in person.
You haven't killed yourself yet? Would you please just die? They got what they wanted.
She says it continued even after she complained to school officials.
I told them, you know, Becca's being threatened. You know, these girls are saying that they're going to jump her. And, oh, well, we'll talk to them. And then, you know, she would still get jumped.
Norman says the bullying began last December. She did everything she could think of, moved her daughter to another school, and even closed Rebecca's Facebook account. But Polk County Sheriff Grady Judd says the torment didn't stop.
And here's some of the quotes that we found. You should die. Why don't you go kill yourself?
Her mother was unaware Rebecca had recently started using new forms of social media, designed as easy ways for people to stay in touch.
The bullying continued by a group of female juveniles on different social media outlets such as Kick, AskFM, Instagram, and Voxer.
Finally, it was too much. Rebecca texted a friend saying, "I'm dead. I'm jumping. I can't take it anymore." On Monday, she climbed a tower at a concrete factory and jumped off. Detectives later found even more ominous clues.
We also found on Rebecca's search engines or search questions, how many Advil do you need to take to die?
The sheriff's office is considering filing charges against the students who sent the hostile messages. Jack, Don Taylor, thank you very much.
Yes, we do set restrictions for the kids with their cell phones. they're not allowed to have their cell phones at dinner. So I think it's important to sit down and talk during dinner with the family. And they are not allowed to bring their cell phones upstairs when they go to bed, when they go to sleep. They can charge them overnight in their rooms, but they're not allowed to use them. Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself. Standing in the Hall of Fame. Cell phones make it easier for people to hide from each other.
Oh my God, he's so cute and so nice. He's the best.
Texting can create fake relationships, and then when you're actually with that person, you can act completely different.
According to studies, men believe that texting hurts relationships. People have access to anyone they know right in their pocket, making it hard for anyone to genuinely miss someone.
But they're also hurting society because they take away from people experiencing things in the moment.
When I was a young girl, we spoke on the phone to one another, and now I don't think the kids talk to each other enough. It's impersonal. It's too impersonal. Kids are losing their communication skills by being texting each other all the time. They are losing the ability to walk up to somebody and talk to them. All they're doing is writing things on the phone all the time, and you lose your communication skills. You don't know how to talk to people.
According to the HIS, teens say that the greatest advantages of texting are that you can multitask and avoid verbal communication.
Pop, what do you think about the constant use of cell phones?
Well, the constant use of cell phones to me is extremely annoying. I can understand if you have to make a call or you want to make an occasional call, in public especially, but the constant use to me is extremely annoying.
Doctors have been discovering that cell phone addiction, in some severe cases, is linked with childhood obesity.
When I'm hanging out with my friends, sometimes it gets annoying because, like, they're all on their phones at once, and I'm just sitting there like, come on, let's do something. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closes.
Over the years, I love watching children play outside. They'd be with their basketball games and the baseball games and the sleds and the bicycles. Today, when you look out the window, you see them all sitting on a curb or at a corner with nothing else but their cell phones in their hand. So when do they have the time to establish a new friendship with a child in the neighborhood or to do other things, other games? It's all cell phone. Drives me crazy. I
but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get.